Hi friends, so let us continue with the next ecosystem, right? Till now we have discussed forest ecosystem in terrestrial ecosystems. Now in this video we will discuss about aquatic ecosystems. Aquatic ecosystems. Now, what is aquatic ecosystem? First, let us see the basic definition here. Now, aquatic ecosystem are a group of interacting organisms depending on one another and their water environment for nutrients, right? Aquatic ecosystem are a group of interacting organisms. Dependent on one another and their water environment for nutrients Now, what are these major nutrients that they will obtain? Nitrogen and phosphorus. Now see here, we will discuss about nitrogen cycle and phosphorus cycle in detail, right? Phosphorus. Right? And now see here, they are dependent on their water environment for nutrients, it seems, and for shelter, right? Now this is their shelter. Done. Now, examples of aquatic ecosystems are, now you can easily say, right, rivers, lakes, ponds, oceans, etc. Right? Now, aquatic ecosystems are the biggest ecosystems. Now, they cover at an around of 71% of Earth's surface. 71% of Earth's surface is covered by aquatic ecosystem, right? Now, in this 71% aquatic ecosystem, I mean 71% of your Earth's surface is nothing but your aquatic ecosystem, and in this you will be observing 97% of your water. Right? Now, and again, in this aquatic ecosystem, marine ecosystem contains more nutrients. Minerals. Now, these aquatic ecosystems are divided into distinct zones based on characteristics, right? Now see here, these aquatic ecosystems are divided into distinct zones. how they are divided into distinct zones based on the characteristics. Now, what are the first characteristics? Such as depth. And the next one is tidal flow. And the next one is temperature. And the next one is right proximity to land masses. Proximity means nearer or farer to the land. Proximity to land masses. Now see here, sometimes they are divided into distinct zones depending upon the light also. Light penetrated. Right? Light penetrated. Now we will see different types of ponds and lakes, I mean different types of aquatic ecosystems based upon this characteristics. Right? Now, based upon the above characteristics and parameters, now this aquatic ecosystems are divided into two parts, right? Now, see here, based upon the nutrients available, aquatic ecosystems are divided into two parts: freshwater ecosystems and marine water ecosystems. Marine water ecosystems. Now, let us first discuss in detail regarding the freshwater ecosystems. Freshwater ecosystems. Freshwater ecosystem. Right now, this freshwater ecosystem, again, they are divided into two categories. Right now, standing bodies of water. Right, standing bodies of water, now which includes lakes and ponds, and moving bodies of water, the rivers and streams. Right now, observe here, this freshwater ecosystems are again divided into two types. First one is standing bodies of water. Now focus on this. This is very important topic in your environment. And the next one is moving bodies of water. Moving bodies of water. Right. Now examples for standing bodies are lakes and ponds. Now, moving bodies of water examples are rivers and streams. Right? Now, what are the basic characteristics of this freshwater ecosystem? Now, these freshwater ecosystems are limited by solar radiation and temperature. Solar radiation and temperature. Right. Now, what are the limitations of freshwater ecosystems? Now, it was a question asked in 2016. Right, focus on this. Now let us discuss in detail regarding the standing bodies of water, lakes and ponds. Okay, let us discuss in detail regarding lakes and ponds. Right, now these lakes and ponds, right, now these lakes and ponds are divided according to their manufacturing or production of organic matter. Now these lakes and ponds are divided or classified based on their production of organic matter. Right, now based on this production of organic matter, now what this organic matter production means, right? Now you will discuss two more points, right? Now this is nothing but basis on their nutrient content, or we will call it as productivity, right? Now based, now these lakes or ponds are classified based on their production of organic matter. Now this organic matter is nothing but your nutrient content. Now into how many types these were divided? Now these lakes and ponds are divided into three types based on this production of organic matter, right? Now those three are nothing but oligotrophic, the next one is eutrophic, and the next one is mesotrophic, observe what is this trophic means, right? Troph means nourishment, right? Nourishment or nutrient content available, right? Nourishment available or nutrient content available. Now let us discuss in detail regarding this oligotrophic lakes. Now what does this mean? A newly formed lake generally has a small supply of plant nutrients, so such types of lakes are called oligotrophic lakes. Now these lakes are not very productive and hence does not contain much life, right? Now see here, I will summarize the things. A newly formed lake now in a newly formed lake there will be small supply of plant nutrients. Now such types of lakes are called oligotrophic lakes. Now these lakes, are not very productive, and contain, doesn't contain much life. Right? Got the point? Now see here, based on the nutrient content or productivity, lakes and ponds are divided in three types: oligotrophic, eutrophic, and mesotrophic. Now we have discussed regarding oligotrophic lake. Now next we will discuss about eutrophic. Eutrophic lakes or ponds. Eutrophic lakes or ponds. Now, what are the characteristics, right? Now, a lake with larger excess supply of plant nutrients is said to be eutrophic, or eutrophic, the other word is well nourished, right? The other word for eutrophic is well nourished. Right, now what you will say, a lake with large or excess supply of plant nutrients is called eutrophic lake. Plant nutrients is called eutrophic lake. Now already we have discussed what are these plant nutrients: nitrogen and phosphorus. Nitrogen and phosphorus. Right, now see here, what are the characteristics of this lake? These lakes are normally shallow and have murky brown or green water. Murky green or brown water. Why? Due to excess supply of plant nutrients, right? With pure quality, right? With poor quality. Now, okay, done. Now, next type of lake according to the classification of nutrients is mesotrophic. What are mesotrophic ponds or lakes? Right, now see here, many lakes, now up to now what we have discussed, they might be having excess plant nutrients or less plant nutrients. Now the lakes which are in between these two zones are called mesotrophic lakes. So they have moderate nutrient content and moderate amount of plant nutrients, and they are reasonably productive, right? Now the lakes which contains, I mean the lakes which contains nutrients, which contains nutrients in between the zones of oligotrophic and eutrophic are called mesotrophic lakes. Now, as the definition itself says, these mesotrophic lakes have moderate nutrients. Moderate phytoplankton means the plants which are grown in water. Phytoplankton. Now automatically they are reasonably productive, observe here. Now, which are highly productive lakes? By observation, you can say that eutrophic lakes are highly productive lakes. Highly productive lakes. Got the point? Yes. Now, the next concept. Now, observe here. Now, you have classified the ponds and lakes based on the nutrient content available. Right? Now, let us discuss about the productivity of the lakes. Right? Now, let us discuss about the productivity of the lakes, now, which is very important. Focus on this. Productivity of lakes. Right? Now, on what factors this regenerative capacity or you can speak it as the productivity of lakes can be determined? Now, this productivity of lakes is determined by several factors, right? Now, what are those factors? The first factor is temperature. The next one is depth of the lake. The next one is nutrient content of the lake. And the next one is, the next important is dissolved oxygen content. Dissolved oxygen. Now, there will be one question every year based on this dissolved oxygen content, right? Now, let us discuss in this detail. Now, let us discuss the first factor, temperature. Now, what can you say? How the productivity of lakes depends upon, is determined by temperature. Now, lakes having less temperature has very low productivity. Similarly, lakes containing excessive amount of nutrients have high productivity. Right? Now, lakes having lesser temperature have low productivity, low productivity. Now, the lakes having excessive amount of nutrients, excess amount of nutrients have high productivity. Now, got the point? Now, the next one is, now see here, dissolved oxygen content. Now, what is this? Right, let us discuss in this in detail. Now, dissolved oxygen content is extremely vital for the process of respiration and photosynthesis. It determines the types of organisms that can inhabit in a lake. Moreover, decomposition of organic matter by bacteria and fungi also requires oxygen as they perform respiration, right? Thereby diminishing the amount of dissolved oxygen content. Now, see here, first let us see the definition and then I'll sum up all the things what I have discussed. The amount of oxygen. Amount of oxygen present in the lake or pond is nothing but your dissolved oxygen content. Now, how this dissolved oxygen content will affect? Now, this DO, dissolved oxygen content, is vital for the process of respiration, photosynthesis. Now see here, if the DO, dissolved oxygen content, is higher, automatically productivity of lake will be higher. Am I right? Now when will this dissolved oxygen content decreases in the given pond or lake? Right, now see here, when decomposition of organic matter is done by bacteria and fungi. Now they need oxygen for respiration, right? In order to carry out this decomposition process, right? So thereby what happens, there will be diminishing of DO. Automatically the lake nourishment and productivity will be decreasing, right? Now this is the point to be noted, right? You have to focus on this, right? Now next one, the next concept. Now you have divided this lakes and ponds into different types based upon the nutrient content availability as oligotrophic, eutrophic and mesotrophic. Now let us divide these lakes and ponds into different zones. How they are divided into different zones and what are those zones? Now this lakes ponds are divided into different zones. Now what are those zones? First one is littoral zone. Next one is limnetic zone. Next one is profundal zone. And the next one is benthic zone. Right? Now, how they are divided into these different types of zones, right? Based on the light penetration, right? And also what we have discussed, one more point there, proximity of land masses. Right, and also divided according to their dissolved oxygen content, where you can get more oxygen and less oxygen in these zones. Right, now we will discuss this in detail in the next video. Right, thank you.